Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. I'm going to go explore the cliff underside, but before that, I want to spend my souls before I lose them. So let's put one point into Vigor, putting me from 515 hit points to 550.
Farewell, Ashen.
Also, let's go check really quick if I have enough shards or whatever they're called to upgrade my weapon. I probably don't. No, I've got 4 and I need 6.
Prithee, be careful.
I'm surprised how slowly I'm getting shards. My poor weapon's only +2. I guess I am just barely into this game, really. I don't even think I've played it for 10 hours. Okay, so that's where I came from to get here, so over here's the new place. Yeah, this is gonna take me up where those people are that throw firebombs and stuff. Got their backs to me. Perfect. Secrets? No secrets. Is there something inside the chimney? No. I see you. I also see you. Hopefully the enemies don't hear me shooting. Good, they didn't. Partisan? Looks like a spear. Let's see how it compares to the S-stock. Where are you? Requires a bit of strength, bit of dexterity, I've got all of that. Okay. It does approximately the same damage. I mean, obviously less at the moment, but my weapon's physical damage is increased by all the upgrades, so I think if you upgrade the Partisan to +2, it'd probably be about the same. Significantly heavier. Okay, so it seems pretty comparable. Aside from the weight, its stats look pretty much the same. Looks like it doesn't scale. Yeah, it doesn't scale as well. If you look at the attribute bonus for strength, both of them have a D rating. So that's the same, but for dexterity, my current weapon has a C, and this one has a D, which is worse. So that means it's not going to gain as much damage increase when I increase my dexterity. It's not going to give it as much of a bonus. But still, they're pretty similar. So let's actually just try and see what the moveset's like. Okay, as you'd expect. Stabby, stabby spear. Does this take more stamina to poke than the S-stock? Maybe. I get 4 pokes before I'm out. Strong attack. It's like a slash. Oops, didn't mean to do that. And special attack is what? Okay, so it's got some AoEs. I like how fast the special attack is, compared to the S-Talk and stuff like that has quite a bit of lead-up. This one is almost instant. That would be nice for crowd control. How's my equipment load? Oh, 72%. Does that mean I slow roll? Oh, I do. No, it's too heavy. It's funny, when you slow roll, not only do you just look kind of stupid, but the controller also vibrates every time you roll. Normally it doesn't. God, I want to test it, but that rolling is a big problem. I'll test it on these enemies, though. These ones aren't too hard. See if I can get a backstab in. Actually, let's use the special. No! Shit! No, don't do that! Oh my god. I had to use my Estus. Goodbye. Down to the abyss. Pyromancy ahead. Oh. Hello. Alright, well this weapon's kinda cool, but I think I'll stick with the S-Stock. Where's my S-Stock? There you are.
Aha! Unkindled, are we? Welcome to my abode. I am Cornix, an old pyromancer. A crow in his cage, as you see now. But here we are. An encounter for the ages. I hear the unkindled make for fine vessels. Care to learn some pyromancies from this old man?
Well, I don't use magic, but sure.
Most wise. A chance encounter should not be squandered. To reiterate, I am Cornix of the Great Swamp. The pleasure is mine.
So they'll be back at my base? My base. I probably shouldn't call the hub area my base. It's not as if I made it. I'm trying to see if there's anything I can fall down onto. I know I can fall down onto this roof, but I don't think that would lead me anywhere. Doesn't look like it. I think that's it. Okay, so I want to go down to the floor by taking the elevator. I guess I'll just go this way. Yeah, let's just go this way. Gonna run past y'all. I'm actually gonna kill you. And the reason for that is I wanna go see what's over here. Is this a locked door? Perhaps the sewer key might unlock it? No, it doesn't open from this side. Really want to know what that sewer key's for. I know I've encountered a couple locked doors. Or at least one locked door. Not just doesn't open from the side, but actually locked. And I don't remember where it was. No! I don't want to go up. We're fine. We're fine. Try door. Oh, right. This is where it said bonfire up ahead. Run past it. One of the tips. Whoa. You are really angry. Jesus Christ! Can you give me an opening, please? Where are my openings? I don't see an opening! It never stops. That thing is insane! Oh my god. Maybe I will try running past it and see if there's actually a bonfire right past it. Because if so, that would be nice. Because I think it's going to take quite a few tries. Angry. Please don't fall down here. Please don't fall down here. Oh, thank God. If it fell onto the elevator, I'd be pretty screwed. Please let me get my souls. Please. Okay. Do I run past it? Yes. I'm gonna see if I can sneak around quietly. If not, then I'm gonna start running. Nope. Open! Bonfire! Oh, thank God, it really was just past the door. Can you leave? Are you stuck there? I think it's stuck there. Oh, man, I wish I didn't just discover this. Because it can't leave, I just realized I can totally cheese this enemy just by doing this. Wait till it walks away, stab it in the butt. That's so cheap, though. Nah, let's make this a fair fight. Irithyll straight sword. Let's see. Damage is really good. It does almost as much damage as my S-Stock, and it's not even upgraded. Stat requirements are pretty similar. They both scale this. No, the dexterity scaling's actually worse. Interesting. This might be something I want to use. Let's try the moveset and see how. See how something? I forgot what I was going to say. Oh yeah, see how long it is. That's nowhere near as long. It's got a fast attack though, that's for sure. Just about the same as the S-Stock in terms of attack speed with the light attack. It's a heavy attack. Big stab, here's the special attack. Whoops. Oh right, it's the same for like most swords like this. It does this, and then if you do a light attack, it does that. Do a strong attack, it does that. Okay. It's really frosty looking. Oh, it does frost damage too. I missed that. Yeah, 35 frost damage. Which really is not much. At least I don't think so. Wait, that's not frost damage. Yeah, sorry, that's not frost damage. No. That's frost effect. You see how there's attack power and has physical, magic, fire, lightning, dark, critical? That's the ones that actually affect the direct damage. The additional effects are bleeding, poison, I'm guessing the middle one is, and then frostbite. So yeah, that, I don't know what the 35 means, but it's not actually damage, it's like how much it adds to the frostbite meter or something like that. So don't think I want to use that, but let's take a look at the description for it, because it seems like a special weapon. Straight sword bestowed upon the Outrider Knights of the Boreal Valley. This weapon is enshrouded in frost and causes frostbite. Every Outrider Knight one day devolves into a beast, constantly hounded by Pontiff Sullivan's black eyes. Was that one of the beasts then? The Outriders had turned into? Wait a minute. Where is this? Is this not even in the Undead Settlement anymore? No, it's somewhere new. It's outside of the Undead Settlement. Okay. That leaves a big question. This elevator didn't take me down to the valley that I saw beneath the main area. It took me to a completely new region, which means there's still something very unexplored back here in the Undead Settlement. And I'm guessing it might have something to do with the key. Only thing is, I can't remember where the hell those locked doors were. So, hold on, I'm gonna cut here and I'll be back when I find something. Actually, before I do that, let me spend my souls to level up, because I feel like I'm probably gonna die running from place to place. Let's put one point into vitality. Yeah, because I'm pushing up against the equipment load limit. At least the 70% limit, because I don't want a slow roll.
Farewell, Ashen One.
You know what? I just think I found a new area that I never explored. Remember here at this kind of hub, where I shot down, I guess, Loretta from up there and got her bone? And also where this... the first time I encountered these giant, like, witch enemies? I don't think I ever went across the bridge. Because I just killed a couple enemies here, and then I looked around and I'm seeing bodies that I never picked up items from. There's one there. There's also a hidden path back here. Yeah, I think I never went here. Whoa! I heard their steps. Okay, this is bad, actually. Run! believe I took so much damage from those weak-ass enemies. Someone's playing with a flame burge. Can I have it? Oh. I've been here before. That's the cliff underside, right down there. Okay, let's go check out the secret path. There's two whoa! Two pathways. Really? Gotta watch your steps there, buddy. Blow darts. Ow. Okay, problem. Oh god, no! Fuck! As soon as I dodged, I knew, like, oh, I'm going over the side. Hey, at least I brought one down with me. It's okay, it's easy to get back there. Please get out of my way. I'm just going down here so I can get away from the arrows. What's the point of this place? Did it just suicide off the cliff? Things are annoying. Plank shield? Sounds rustic. makeshift shield cobbled together from wooden planks. Provides minimal protection, and at the cost of moderate humiliation. Why would anyone want to use that? That sounds terrible. Oh, that is so sad. It's like someone just hacked off a chunk of fencing and used it as a shield. Body up there. Oh, that's what that place is for. It's so you can get back. That's a terrible fight. Got hit like 5 times. Hope the body doesn't fall all the way down there. Got it! It did fall down. Thank God I got it so quickly. Flame Stoneplate Ring. Increases fire damage absorption. Huh, okay. So will my stats actually tell me how much it increases it by? No, status. It was fire? My absorption is 34. Okay, it looks like everything else is around 18, so I'm guessing it probably added about 15, 16 to my fire damage absorption. All there is up here. It's probably mostly for that ring. Okay, well I'm gonna go back to searching for the locked door that I can unlock with my sewer key. Oh, you know what? I think I know where it is. I think the locked door is... Yeah, it's gotta be next to the rat. Right? There's probably a door down here. It's just a kind of sewery place. Completely covered. It's gotta be... Oh, that one probably. Please let it be this one. Yes! Loincloth. It's worse at everything, although for some reason it absorbs more magic and dark. Also protects you more against curse and poison. Huh. I've got to see this. I wish there was a way to disable displaying armor, rather than just unequipping it. So Lothric, Northern Gloves. Okay. Aw, yeah. God damn, Alima's freaking muscled. Now I can super far roll. Because I'm at where is it? 15.9% weight ratio. Let's go with it. Why not? What's the worst that could happen? Halberd! Special halberd! Special halberd? And I can use it too! It requires more dexterity and less strength. That's perfect for my build. Absolutely perfect. Oh my god. I'm looking at the differences in the design. Ironically enough, it doesn't look as pretty as the basic halberd. But that's okay. Just matters how it works. So, it does more damage. Yeah, it does more damage. It's got a D in both scalings. The only difference is it kind of reallocated two from the strength into the dexterity. The FP cost is also less, so perhaps it has... Oh, it does have a different ability. This one's ability is charge, this one's ability is perseverance. I want to take a look at the description of it in just a second. Just equip it there. Oops. Long-hilted weapon. Mixing spear and axe. The red-hilted halberd is associated with clerics. Can be thrust like a spear or swept sideways like an axe, making it a versatile weapon effective against multiple foes. Perseverance. Assume an unfaltering stance of prayer to temporarily boost poise. Damage reduced while activated. Hmm. So it's got the slow stabs. Much slower than the S-Doc. But it's also significantly longer. Strong attack. Kind of the big sort of AoE. And let's pray. Nope. Two-handed. Pray. Yeah. I wonder how long that lasts for. Assuming it lasts as long as the visual effect, then I guess it only lasts for, like, 3 seconds. Let's try this thing out. Oh, hi. Ooh, nice! These enemies are really cool. The way they assemble themselves, oh, it's so cool. Ooh, I love that AoE on this thing. I really like this weapon. I do like the speed of the S-Doc, though. I mean, there's no harm in having two weapons, right? Oh no, I'm all covered in mud. Or... could it be mud? I don't even know if it's wet down here. Maybe it's zombie juice. I feel like the special effect is just... the special attack is just... bleh. I mean, my entire playstyle is to avoid getting hit. So I feel like the increase in poise is only useful for a shield build. For me, it's like, what's the point? If I'm not gonna get hit, then boosting my damage reduction for a couple seconds and my poise is, like, useless. That's sort of like a, you know, hunker down and defend yourself from a big attack from a boss or something like that kind of thing, but I just don't get hit. Or at least I attempt to not get hit. So I don't like that. That's interesting. Yeah, if you roll and then do an attack, it actually doesn't do a spear-like attack, it does a kind of like a sideswipe. So a normal light attack is like this. But if you roll and then light attack, it does that coming out of it. That's nice. That means you don't have to be quite as exact where you aim when you go to roll attack. So, I'm just thinking, the other halberd I have, if the only difference between the two is basically just the 5 points of damage, then I might as well just get up the skill points to use this halberd, because for this halberd I'm actually going to, I would actually use the special attack. It has a normal kind of attacking thing. It charges with it. Whereas this one does something that I'm probably never going to use, Perseverance. But at least this serves as a nice testbed to see whether I'm going to like using the halberd in Dark Souls 3. And then if I do, which I'm pretty sure I do, then I can swap to the other one once I have enough strength. Lizard ahead. Try dashing through. Where? Oh. Oh, yeah, now I'm down here finally. Yes! I'm scared if I dash towards it, though, a bunch of enemies are gonna come out. Who cares? Let's do it.
Come back here! Oh!
Yes! I'm sorry I had to kill you. You're cute. But you have valuable minerals. Oh, something's coming. Oh, shit! I really like this weapon. Reminds me of why I liked it so much in Dark Souls 2. Visions of above, indeed. Yeah, it was that one from up there that was kind of peering over the edge. It jumps down. Try up and then let there be shield. Oh! I thought I meant enemy. Ooh, yeah, you know what? If I want to use the halberd, I'm gonna also need to increase my vitality quite a bit, so I won't be over 70% weight when I'm using it. Blessed red and white shield plus one. Don't use shields, but that sounds pretty cool. Standard round wooden shield. Features a striking red and white design. So the description is not special, but it does say blessed. So what does blessed actually mean? Oh, it scales with faith, or whatever that is. Mob enemy. Ah, yes, rats. This halberd will actually be pretty nice against them. At least the AoE will be. The stab, not so much. You're gonna come out. Yep. No! Too long charge! Oh, come on! Let me get it off. Please. Please, please, please. No! 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 Fuck me! I literally couldn't move. Oh. Man, that AoE is slow. I love it, but it's slow. Alright, let's put my stuff back on. This is the one I use, right? Yeah. Yeah, it was Lothric. What was this one? Northern? Yeah, Northern. Lothric, Northern. Northern again? Yep, there we go. Oh, how's my weight? 81%! No! I'm slow rolling. What if I get rid of the S-Stock? 74? Ah, I'm still slow rolling. Okay, I'm just gonna put the halberd down for now. Or should I? Should I? Nah, I'll just take off my helmet. I want to try it out some more. Oh, right, these. Expecting that. Yeah, the AoE is really good at knocking enemies down. Wait, where did you come from? You weren't here before. Okay. Nope. I did 4 damage to them. Yay. Let me get the fucking AoE off! I hate you, rats. There, and barely did anything. Fuck my life. Maybe this weapon isn't so good against mobs. Just... oh man, those 2 seconds before the AoE gets off is just way too long. The entire time, enemies just hit you once and you're interrupted. Yes. Tight spot. Time for rear. Oh. Is that Dark Souls players being jackasses?
Who is there? Someone there? Anyone? Oh, please. Whoever you are, touch me. The dark surrounds me, nibbles at my flesh. Little creatures. They never stop biting. So please, hold out your hand and touch me.
I feel like something bad's going to happen.
Ah, yes, there you are. So close, indeed. And I am not entirely alone, just yet. Praise the merciful gods above. Oh, forgive me. I am Irina of Karim. I came to this land so that I might be a firekeeper. Your touch has freed me from the darkness. You are a champion, then. I am weak and unfit to tend the flames. But if it would not trouble you, might I enter into your service instead?
Of course. The more the merrier.
Oh, thank you, sweet champion. I shall take my vows. I, Irina of Karim, solemnly swear to serve you.
Now I feel like I'm truly done with the undead settlement. I think that's everything. I can't think of any other unexplored pathways, or locked doors or anything.
You've gone and rescued her, have you? How very quaint. Pitying creatures that are beyond help. Very well. I'm sick of looking after her at any rate. I am Egon, a knight of Karim. I am allied to you for as long as you assure the girl's safety. And only for that long. What's the matter? My terms are very simple. I am allied to you for as long and only...
I'm guessing next time I go back to the hub, they'll be there. Okay, so I've got two new people to talk to. And a new place to explore. Let's go ahead and use a homeward bone. I'll end this episode here. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm going to talk to the people that I just brought into my service, and go explore the new zone.